Okay, another type of CAM therapy, stimulation therapies, acupuncture, and I put in neurostimulation into this because I think it's important in that it's a therapy that's not a pharmacotherapy, and it's a therapy that we think has a big placebo effect involved in it. Deep brain stimulation for the relief of pain. This is a patient that has an electrode implanted in his thalamus, and that he can stimulate himself, stimulate. And this is there are patients that get thalamic stimulation, others that get motor cortex stimulation. There had been others that they tried to stimulate in the periaqueductal gray, knowing that that's an important part of pain modulatory circuitry, but it didn't work so well in patients because it works very well when they'd stimulate in rats, but when you stimulate in patients, even though it reduced their pain, they had this horrible feeling of impending doom. And they said, never stimulate there again. So that didn't really work out so well, but stimulating the thalamus and the motor cortex has been used. So what we did is we took patients that had had successful treatment with this deep brain stimulation for years, and then we brought him into the lab and we said, okay, we're going to test out some new stimulation parameters and to see if we can see if these new parameters are better or worse than your current parameters. So first of all, we just stimulated them using their normal parameters, and we had the stimulator turned off, and there's their pain ratings, intensity, unpleasantness. Stimulator on, the intensity and pleasantness go down, you turn it back off, and it goes back up. Okay, that's what you expect. But then, again, this just shows that when you do the slap, that's what from the last slide. But then, we basically told them, we had in front of the oscilloscope, and we had these other waveforms, and we said, this is a new pattern, you may or may not feel it, because you get a paresthesia with the thalamic stimulation, a buzzing, a tingling sensation in the area that where the stimulator is. So basically, we turned off the stimulator, and we basically got the same thing. This was the ratings before. We turned it off. We even got a bigger effect than with their normal stimulation, and that even lasted a little bit longer than the normal stimulation. So this was a new stimulation. It had even a more profound effect, or as profound as their normal stimulation. And the neurosurgeons, I say, well, you can't do a placebo control because they can feel the stimulation, and if you don't turn it on, they can't feel it. And we told them, you may or may not feel this new stimulation, but lo and behold, they felt the new stimulation, which was actually no stimulation. They still felt the paresthesia. And so here are the paresthesia ratings and how they relate to the pain, their pain perception. And the bigger the paresthesia, the lower the pain ratings, and you found the same thing with the placebo paresthesias. We even had one patient that said, stop the stimulation, it's too strong. So we all have, it's real, it's in our systems that we have this natural placebo responsiveness, which I'll just get to a little bit later to go into really what's happening with placebo. It's not imaginary, it's not because the person's crazy, and we'll get there in a little bit. Okay. Acupuncture is another type of stimulation that seems to have a strong placebo effect. This is from the group at Harvard, and they had verum stimulation and placebo stimulation, and they had at the meridian site and a non-site. So here with the verum stimulation, when the person has a very high expectation of pain relief, you get a nice pain relief and at the correct site, but not at the incorrect site. But if they have a low expectation, it goes away. But if you do placebo stimulation, you're getting an effect, not quite as strong, but you're getting an effect as long as you have a high expectation, even without having the real needling. And so although you have these effects in both cases, when they did the brain imaging, what they found is that the real acupuncture actually activated different parts of the brain than the placebo expectation-related acupuncture. So even though both work, they may not be working through the same mechanisms. And this is something that, again, hasn't been followed up on, but I think it's important. Just because you get the same behavioral output doesn't mean it's the same mechanisms happening in the brain. And I think it's really something that needs to be investigated further.